Fog began at last to open up before my eyes, and there I saw, to my surprise, chains and specks of islands curved where palm trees dipped and seagulls swerved. I parked my kayak on a stone, yelled across the ocean to his evil throne. I said, Wilson, someday I'll kill you to die. Oh, Wilson, punch you in the eye. Wilson, kill you to die. Oh, Wilson, punch you in the eye. Thank you. the bathtub, making soup for the ambassador. And I'm in the hallway, singing to the troubadours, and the kings are all lined up outside the gate. And the autumn bell is ringing, but don't just have to wait. Where is the Joker? Have you seen him around with his new cold cap that he wears like a crown? Have you seen his striped stockings and heard his sad tale of the kids under the carpet and the purple humpback whale? Show up one by one, Grin is tasting all the soup to see if it is done. And Wendy's on the windowsill, waiting to be let in. And we're all in the bathtub now, making bathtub gin. When the kings storm the hallway, they've climbed up through the gate. They didn't mean to be impolite, but they just couldn't wait. Where is the Joker? He carries a martini made of bathtub gin. Thank you. stare through the corridor. I came upon an aging knight who leaned against the wall in gnarly armor. He was on his way to see the king. Wilson, Wilson, Wilson. He led me through the streets of pressure talking as he tried to crush a bug that stirred underneath his pavilion. He said there was a place where we should go. So it led me through the forest, to the edge of a lagoon, by which we wandered till we reached a bubbly spring. The night grew very quiet as we stood there. He lifted up his visor and he turned to me and he began to say, he said, his name is Rutherford the Brave, and he was on a quest to save his people from the fate that lived before them. Their clumsy end was perilously near. The lizards would be saved, he said, if they could be aligned by the writings of the helping friendly book. That any person who possessed it was a crow. He said, I come from the land of the lizards. He said, I come from the land of doom. He said, I come from the land of demons. From the land of the big baboon. But I never ever going back there. And I couldn't if I tried. Cause I come from the land of lizards. And the lizards, they have died. Possess the ancient secrets of eternal joy and never-ending splendor. The trick was to surrender to the flow. We walked along beneath the moon. He led us through the bush till soon. We saw before our eyes a raging river. He said we can swim it if we try. Saying as the night dove in, forgetting that his suit of arms would surely weigh him down, and so he sunk. And as his body disappeared before me, I bowed my head in silence and remembered all the thoughts that he had thought. He said, I come from the man. Oh,
Thank you.
sometimes when you just coast along. But like it or not, something always seems to go wrong. Sometimes people build you up just so they can knock you down. Sometimes they will have you there because they need someone around. Perhaps you'll receive invitations for tea. Perhaps you will laugh and you'll make them all smile. Or maybe you'll join them because it had to be. Perhaps you'll forget that you forgot for a while. Dance. A pulse isn't ringing, you can't find a chance. A ritual drumming, although at first glance, you thought you could run, but you won't take a chance. It's not an experience if they can't bring someone along. They hang on emotions, they bottle inside, they peck at the ground, and they strut out of stride. Thank you. Esther first saw the Armenian man who groveled toward her and stood by her side with a bucket that swung in his hand. His grin stretched the folds of his pasty white cheeks, and his lips held a dollop of murk on the curb, and the lights from the ride showed a mischievous sparkle that flashed in his hollow-eyed stare. He said, "Little girl, you can chop off my legs and then peel off my socks if you want to. But I'd rather you took this old puppet from me that I hold in my pail as we speak." And he stood looking down at the innocent girl, and she stared at the bucket, bewildered, till he lifted the doll for the young girl to see, and a giant smile grew on her face. She saw the doll's eyes, and she couldn't resist, and she thanked the man quickly and ran to the church, and she burst through the doorway with puppet held high, and a hush filled the chapel, and the people looked mean. Pacify the mob, quibble grew to spat, to wrangle, then to brawl. The frenzied congregation struggled desperately to fetch the pretty puppet snugly nestled deep in Esther's leather sack. Through the window of the church, a storm began to rage, and Esther knew the time had come to flee. Scurried down the aisle toward the doorway in the distance and out into the rainstorm where she felt she would be free. But the wind was blowing harder and her skirt began to billow until finally her feet began to lift. She rose above the houses and the people and the chimneys, and Esther and the doll were set adrift, floating higher over the hills and the valleys and treetops. They flutter and glide, soaring and turning, suspended on air. With the earth far below them, they tumble and dive through the clouds. sure to find the evil men who rob and pillage in the darkest hour of night. Nervously she fumbled for the pouch that held the puppet on her rope. Feeling quite outnumbered, and standing behind a nearby pile of lumber, where she waited till the dawn. To the streets along the chilly lake that lay beside the town. At last a peaceful moment, but she thought she heard a sound. It was an angry mob of joggers coming up to knock her down. She stood and shook her head. The joggers were approaching, and she knew she had no choice left but to swim. The frosty water sank its bitter teeth into her eye. She tried to slide the heavy clothing from her skin. Naked now, she made her way toward the shore, when suddenly she felt a tiny tugging at her toe. And the puppet she'd forgotten wrapped its tiny little arms around her ankle, and it wouldn't let her go. The waves seemed to open and swallow her whole, as a doll pulled her down through the eerie green deep. And the sound of the laughing old man filled her ears as she drifted away to a tranquil and motionless sleep.
Get their share of darkness and of love.
peacefulness dreaming dreams brings. If life were easy and not so fast, I wouldn't think about the past. We'll be right back.
when my eyes were washing hers, they closed, and I was still asleep. For when my hand was holding hers, she whispered words, and I awoke. And faintly bouncing round the room, the echo of who never spoke. And I awoke, faintly bouncing round the room, the echo of who never spoke. The place I saw was far beneath the surface of the sea. My sight was poor, but I was sure the sirens sang a song for me. They dance above me as I sink. I see them through a crystal haze, and hear their sweet sound bouncing round the never-ending coral maze. The crystal haze, and hear them bouncing round the room.
Thank you. Thank you.
Looking in this direction for the last half an hour or something, but you might want to take a glance at what we get to look at while we're playing.
That's where I am. No. Thank you. Thank you.
Esquadrillas.
Thank you.
This one is for you. This one is for you. This one is for you. This one is for you. This one is for you. This one is for you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I'm bought for the price of a flag and no price. The wind busts the cabin, speak of your life, all my willing locus of it. What you can of the inning, and revise your despise so many. Cause I soak up the wrath that you didn't quite mask. I'm getting it clearly, the ultimate pass on the stain of the city's name. But you can rely on the facts of my world. I sat in the trees and that's what I suffer. The torture of chalk just collects on my tongue. Thoughts follow my vision in dance in the sun. All my best of the fingers, they come slowly undone. Give this wisdom my mold, can I live while tonight, I plug the distress tube up tight. Watch what I say as it flutters away to where all this emotion, this guitar on this baby, not to educate somebody's pride. All the facts that I've learned, I sat in the chairs and my synapses burn. The torture of chalk just collects on my tongue. Thoughts follow my vision and dance in the sun. All my vessel content is like a slowly undone. If this weighs a lot more, can I live while I'm here? Can I live while I'm here? I sat in the chairs and I set up some blood. The torture of chalk just collects on my tongue. Thoughts follow my vision, dance in the sun. All my massive physics as they come slowly undone. It is with my mole, can I live on you? There's Eric down there. That's Eric. Everybody say hi to Eric. Eric! Eric is our massage therapist. He massages us. See you, Eric. standing on, that will not forsake me till my tale is told and done. While the fire lights aglow, strange shadows in the flames will grow, to things we've never seen, seem familiar. Shadows of the sailor forming, winds both foul and feral swarming. Down in Carlisle he loved a lady many years ago. Here beside him stands a man, a soldier from the looks of him. Came through many fights, but lost in love. While the storyteller speaks, a door within the fire creaks, suddenly flies open, and a girl is standing there. Eyes alight with glowing hair, all the fancy paints as fair. She takes her fan and throws it in the lion's den. Which of you to gain me tell, will risk uncertain pains of hell? I will not forgive you if you will not take a chance. The sailor gave at least a try, the soldier being much too wise. Strategy was his strength, disaster. Thank you.
Thank you.